future of boxing is in good hands. I sound like that Allstate guy. You're in good hands with Allstate. But, on a serious note, the future of boxing is good hands. After what I seen last Saturday night from Jaron Boots Ennis, and after I seen, you know, Vergil Ortiz in his fight with Hooker, I'm impressed. And I'm ready for more. I'm looking forward to the future of boxing and these bright superstars in the making. And it's just not those two. There's more fighters, but those two are the main ones people tend to talk about. We're going to talk about the future of boxing. We're going to talk about Jaron Ennis, Vergil Ortiz, and more next. But don't forget, please don't forget, go ahead and hit that like button. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button so y'all can subscribe to the channel and you won't miss a video. Let's go. What's up, YouTube? How y'all doing? And welcome back to SealsTv. Or welcome. Welcome to SealsTv. As I said in the intro, future of boxing is very bright. I'm very excited, and these guys that are coming up and going to be the future are looking amazing. We just seen Jaron Boots Ennis this past Saturday dominate. Sorry, who is a tough veteran that has been in the ring with the likes of Mikey Garcia, Lamont Peterson, and dominate and stop limping. Yes. It was impressive. I was impressed. I figured that he would come out to dominate and impress and put on a good show, and he did. And, yeah, man, he's the real deal. I mean, we definitely knew that he was the real deal before, but after seeing that, you know, you really never know until you actually see him in there with someone that you actually know is a live opponent. And Sergey Olympias is a live opponent. Now, he looked impressive. He was impressive. Spectacular. And, yeah, like I said, I'm ready for the future. I'm not rushing. I'm not rushing the future. I don't want to rush the future. I don't want to get older. Y'all know what I'm saying. But anyway, Jaron Ennis, Vergil Ortiz, both of these guys are future superstars. They both have... Man, they have the talent. They have everything that you want. You have Vergil Ortiz. Vergil Ortiz is more, both have power, but Vergil Ortiz is more the stalker, the bully, the power puncher. In your face, rough you up, beat you down. And then you got Jaron Ennis. He's more of the personality, you know, the flashy. He's just as equally as strong and powerful as Vergil Ortiz. But he's more of the slicker boxer with the defense and, you know, the head movement and stuff. So both are future fighters, future superstars in the making. Both have different styles, unique styles that make them great. And I'm excited. I'm excited about a future fight between the two, between Jaron Boots Ennis, between Vergil Ortiz. I'm excited about that fight. Hopefully it doesn't take 5 years to make it. But I'm excited. Maybe this is a new era and these guys actually want to fight each other sooner rather than later. But both stepped up. Both look amazing. And I'm excited for their careers. I'm excited to see what they do next. I'm excited to see who Vergil Ortiz fights next. I'm excited to see who Jaron Ennis fights next. Hopefully they get somebody pretty decent. I'd like to see, man, I'd like to see somebody in there with a Keith Thurman. Do I think Keith Thurman would take the fight? No, because it still is a high risk, low reward fight. And I think Keith Thurman is still hoping that he can get a fight with Errol Spence or Terence Crawford, whoever. And Sean Porter is the same. Sean Porter is the mandatory for Terence Crawford. I still think he's holding on to get that fight before trying to fight one of these guys. But there are many other, you know, top 10 guys that I'd like to see Jaron Ennis and Vergil Ortiz in there with. Maybe I'll make a video about that. Maybe I will. Maybe I'll make a video about who I want to see these guys in the ring with next. Stay tuned. But, yeah. These guys, they're the future. Definitely a future. Definitely spectacular. Definitely have the talent, the personalities, everything. But, there's always that but. But, I'm hearing a lot of stuff about Jaron Ennis and Vergil Ortiz beating Errol Spence Jr. and Terence Crawford. Now, I'm not one of those guys. I'm not like, Jaron Ennis looked spectacular Saturday. It was his toughest test to date. But at the same time, Sergey Limpin, yes, he is really maybe a 140-pound fighter. And he ain't Errol Spence. He ain't no Terence Crawford. Now, when I say this, I'm not saying that Vergil Ortiz or Jaron Ennis can't beat Errol Spence Jr. or Terence Crawford right now. I'm not saying that. But what I am saying is put some respect on Errol Spence's name. Put some respect on Terence Crawford's name. Because I'm seeing everybody. I'm seeing everybody say, oh, they can beat Errol Spence and Terence Crawford. Man, Terence Crawford, Errol Spence, they're the top two in that division for a reason. They're the top dogs for a reason. They're the top, easily top, top three, pound for pound in the division. Or pound for pound boxing. Boxing. So, if you are one of those people, you know, there's nothing wrong with thinking that Jaron Ennis can beat Errol Spence or Vergil Ortiz can beat Terence Crawford. But man, y'all gotta put some respect on that name. You gotta put some respect on that name. You got one who is multiple champion, multiple divisions, undisputed champion at 140, you know, WBO champion at 147, Errol Spence, unified champion, IBF, WBC champion at 147. You gotta put some respect on their names. And that's the biggest thing that I've seen is just a lot of people, man. Like, you have to put respect on their names. We've seen many times in the past, we've seen these guys that are young and look like future superstars get into the ring. You know, you got Canelo Alvarez, for example. Canelo Alvarez, young superstar, gets in the ring with Floyd Mayweather, who at the time is the best fighter in the world, hands down. You can't, there's nothing you can say. But Canelo Alvarez beating these guys down, he looked like, you know, the best fighter in the world. He was beating these guys down. And he gets in the ring with Floyd Mayweather, and it's just levels. It's just levels to it. It's levels to boxing. And Floyd Mayweather showed that. Even though that was probably the best thing that ever happened to Canelo Alvarez's career. Because Canelo Alvarez, although he was a beast before, he turned into a whole different beast after the Floyd Mayweather fight. But also, you know, look at Erickson Lubin. Erickson Lubin at the time looked like he was going to be the future of 154. Everybody was real high on Erickson Lubin. What was it, Sledge and Jack, or Jack and Sledge? So they were high on Erickson Lubin. But then he gets in there with, you know, who was the top dog, Romel Charlo, and gets stopped in a highlight reel knockout in the first round. But like I said, I'm not saying that these guys can't beat Errol Spence and Terence Crawford right now. But we're not even giving Errol Spence and Terence Crawford respect after Saturday. But, you know, that's a good thing for Jaron Ennis. You know, I'm glad that he's getting the exposure and actually getting the, you know, getting people talking about him. Because he is a special fighter. He is. So is Vergil Ortiz. Both are equally as special. You know? But, at the same time, them boys over there are equally as special too. Errol Spence, Terence Crawford. But, y'all let me know down in the comments. Would it be too early for Vergil Ortiz and Jaron Ennis to fight Errol Spence and Terence Crawford? Or do you think it's perfect timing? They got the talent to beat them right now. Y'all let me know down in the comments. And, yeah, like I said, these guys are the future of boxing. These guys are superstars. Bona fide superstars. They look spectacular in their first step up, their step up fights. But at the same time, these guys over here, they got the experience and they've been stepping up. So let's just put some respect on their names, especially when it comes to the young fighters, man. Don't try to push them in there when it's still early. You don't want to push somebody in there too early because sometimes they don't come back from that. Not all the fighters are like Canelo Alvarez. Can take a loss and just turn into this even better fighter. So, man, just I say pump the brakes just a little bit. You know, these guys are eventually going to fight Errol Spence and Terence Crawford. Maybe it's not at 147. Maybe it's at 154. But let them keep building up their careers and getting, you know, improving and getting that experience that they need. That's the biggest thing, is the experience. And then we'll get those fights. Honestly, there's Errol Spence got Ugas. Terence Crawford got Manny Pacquiao. After that, they got each other. And after that, there's nowhere to go. There's nobody to fight at 147. There's nobody to fight at 147. That's the thing. Nobody to fight. So if they're going to stay in that weight division, then they're going to have to fight Jaron Ennis. They're going to have to fight Vergil Ortiz. If they move up, Vergil Ortiz already talked about winning a championship and moving up. So Vergil Ortiz is right behind him when he does move up. So eventually these guys are going to fight. I'm just saying, don't rush it too quickly. Let these guys get that experience because, like I said, Sergey Olympias, Maurice Hooker, they're not Terence Crawford. They're not Errol Spence. But